big one. The big one would hurt even more. I think I talked to you yesterday, you know, you can pair it, you know.
But we're gonna do it, so at the beginning, we're gonna do it by yourself first, okay? Do it by yourself first, and then we're gonna use a green pen to discuss. All right, so let's go. So I'll give you guys a minute or two. Write down the claim, evidence, and everything. So Florian, you can work by yourself first, okay? Yeah. Thank you very much. All right, so I'm gonna go around and make sure that everyone is working. So we have, so Steve is not here today. And we have Florian doing well. Well, we just started. Well, you good job. Okay, good job.
Deja.
Okay. So you can put a pun square on the paper, okay? So Joa, Aries, Albert. Yeah, okay, good job. And yeah, take some time, it's okay. Take a look, read carefully the question. So Aries, okay. So it's okay if you really don't know the answer because your class is gonna help. So that's what the green pen is for. You can discuss with the green pen. Stacy is good. Taylor. Okay, so I see a lot of you guys already have some answers on it. Okay, so another 1 minute, then we're gonna talk with your green pen. Again, don't worry, you know, if you don't know the answer, it's okay. You know, you can talk to your classmate and to discuss, to get the answers together. Good. So make sure you put a pattern square on it, okay? So it's okay, so we will talk to your classmate to discuss, okay? Okay, so I see like most of you already have the claim evidence reasoning on it. Okay, and the pattern square, I see the pattern square, nice pattern square is right there. All right, so now I want you guys to use a green pen to talk to your classmate, to ask your classmate what your answer, what the claim is, what the evidence is, what the reasoning is. I want you guys to use a green pen because, for example, you have some answers that you don't know, but your classmate got great ideas. Use a green pen to write it down, okay? So your classmate, great answers. Okay, so let's everyone, let's start using green pen. Okay, so do you have a green pen? Yeah, everyone got a green pen, right? So let's talk to each other right now, and Florida can talk to Luisa, and try to get the conversation going. Okay, so Florida, you can get started. Okay, construct the answers together. Alright, so Kendra, maybe you just put a lead here for now, okay? Just to get some answers. Okay. Yeah, let's go. Would you get great? Good job. Alright, Deja and Kendra, talking already. And we have Therese, Stacy. Conversation is doing really well, I can hear it. I have Kayla is discussing about it, and Luisa, Florida, yep, working on it. Aries, Joe. Okay, so Nick and Albert, you are talking about it, right?
Uh-huh.
Try to get deep into the answers, you know? Ask about what are the answers you don't know, or the answers that you know, then we can compare and contrast the answers. So you two, we got it? Okay, so I guess I see that some people using a green pen already, you know, you got the answer from your classmate. And I got the feedback from your classmate. Good job. Yourself or... Yep, the green pen. So you two got similar answers?
Yeah.
Very similar, okay. All right, so then we can go over that in about 2 minutes or so. So after 2 minutes, we're gonna come together as a class, okay? And I want everyone to be actively raising your hands, though. I mean, when I ask you questions, make sure everyone raising their hands. So I want a lot of feedback from you guys. You know, it's important to get feedback from you guys, okay? So for me, you know what I'm gonna do? I will have my green pen ready, and my So just to get answer from you guys, okay? Because it's not my idea, it's your ideas. But if it's not correct, then other people can, you know, help correct it, okay? So one more minute. Yeah, I want active participation. All right, so let me see. Well, I will go one more round and see. Yep, you got some feedback from your classmate. Good. Let me see right here. So you got a feedback from Stacy, okay?
Which is what we did.
Okay.
Not copy.
Yeah. So try to see what's a good answer and what answer we need to modify. Okay. Thank you so much for providing, you know, some feedback for the classmates. Okay. Good. All right. All right. So I think a lot of you guys already have most of the answers written down on the paper. And now I'm going to ask the claim. Okay, so what's the claim? So basically, what is the answer for this? What's the percentage? What's the chance? Because it's asking about the claim, which is asking about your answer. So if it's a chance that the baby giraffe would have a short neck. What's the chance? I want more participation, but hey, yeah.
There's like a 25% chance.
25% chance. That the baby giraffe has short or long neck. Long or short?
Short.
Yep. And short. Okay. So now I want someone else to tell me like the evidence now. What do you see? Just from this paragraph, or maybe from the Punnett square. What do you see that will help you get to the claim? We have, yep.
Both parents have the small g as a phenotype.
Yep. Yeah, both parents have the big g and small g. Phenotype or genotype?
Genotype,
exactly. So this is a very important information. Both parents, okay, if you really don't know, for example, if you both don't know, use a green pen, okay? Because I'm getting answer actually from Stacy, I'm getting answer from Nate, so I'm using green pen right now. So both parents have the genotype. What's the genotype again? Both?
Small g.
Small g and what?
Big g.
Yeah, big g is small g. And what is it called, or what is this state, of genotypes called? It's
hetero
what? Heterozygous, exactly. So this is a heterozygous, which is right here. I think I have the, let me see. That's not here, which is good. So you understand what heterozygous means. So it's big G and small g. Okay, so now the reasoning, first of all, we need to complete the Punnett square, right? So can someone tell me what this box is for the genotype?
Two capital G's.
Yeah, two capital G's. I want someone else to help me out. Raise your hand. Come on, everyone be active. Yeah. No? Come on. Try it out. What is this?
Lowercase.
Yep. Uppercase G and lowercase G. Good job. And how about this? This box. What? And someone else help me out. Maybe Fallen, Luisa. Can you help me out? What do you think this box is for the genotype?
Capital G, lowercase.
Exactly. Capital G and lowercase g. And the last one is?
Both
lowercase g. Okay. All right. So, Fora, make sure you come facing the board so that you can see what I've written down. Okay? So, thank you very much. So, okay. Now, we got part of the reasoning now. So, we need to calculate it, right? So, we have to calculate it. Let me put a calculation here. Because at the end, we know the claim is 25%. That's what you guys claim, okay? So the calculation is 25%. And how do you know this 25% from this Punnett square? Can someone tell me the calculation? Like, how do you know it's 25%? Yeah.
Because
if you divide 4 by 100.
Divide
100
by
4. Okay, you can do that because total is 100%, right? And there's only, okay, first of all, we have to go back. What is a phenotype for this big G? It's a long one or a short?
Long.
Long, okay. This is long one. How about this one?
Long.
Yeah, this one?
Long.
And
short.
Okay, so meaning that 1 out of 4 is for the short one. We're asking for the short neck, okay? So your calculation is 100 divided by 4. Okay, this is a good way to say that, to do that. And the other way that I'll write down, okay, I like that actually. So the percentage of short neck is basically equal to 100% because total is 100%, just what Stacy said, and divided by 4 because only one of them is short. Okay, that's a good way to do that. It's a very good way to do that. And another way, okay, Florida, I want you to make sure you got this one. This is very important too. It's math. The other way I can put it right here, okay, is basically it's 1/4 because 1/4 and total is 100%. So it's 25%. So I like your idea too, like how you do 1 divided by 4 is 25, but that's another way, alternative way to derive the answer, okay? Because 1 out of 4 boxes is short neck, okay? But total is 100%, so 1 divided by 4 times 100%. Now you got 25%, okay? So any questions so far? So make sure you, if you do not have the answer on the paper, make sure you use a green pen, okay? I give you guys a minute to make sure that everyone got a green pen and write down the answers, okay? If you don't have the answers. Okay, so I'm gonna go around and double check everyone. Okay, good. See, it's, you guys using a green pen really well. Good. I like the drawing. I saw Avery actually drawing the giraffe. Luisa. So I saw Aries. Join the giraffe, and I have a short and long neck. It's pretty nice too. So make sure no cell phone, okay? So Luisa, put the cell phone away. Okay. So Florian, good. All right. So everyone got it now. So we are going to move on to a project that we need to accomplish today. So let me have this one ready. Everyone got it, right? Any questions so far? Florian and Luisa, you got everything written down? Okay, everything modified? Okay, got it? Okay. All right, so let's get going to the project. All right, so the project we are doing,
we're gonna continue.
So this is a new one that we're working on. We're gonna work on a new one.
Why do we keep doing?
So we have a new one to do. Okay, so we have to construct a 3D model of the tunnel square using the Play-Doh and the poster papers. Okay. So the last time we worked on the we worked on other animals, but this time is a very different information. Okay. So we have to construct a 3D model and using the Play-Doh, the poster paper. And then this is the hot product you're going to work on, the hot product. So the hot product right here, so it's what I want to see at the end. So you have to get a poster paper, it's right in the back. And then you have to identify right here the genotype and the phenotype for all the boxes too, okay? All the parents and all the offspring, okay? So the one I put it down right here, Kendall, which you pay attention is that we're using the Play-Doh to get the parent one, using the Play-Doh to make the parent two. Yeah, so hold on a second, let me make sure everyone understand first, okay? So Florian and Paris. So make sure everyone understand first, okay, before you get the poster.
Okay, what?
Yeah, just hold on a second. We are going to let me explain everything first, okay? Yeah. So we have the first box, again, using Play-Doh to describe, actually to show me the phenotype, and also identify the genotype, the same as the other boxes, okay? So now, the questions right here, all the So for the butterflies, we have the long wings is allele F, big F. It's a dominant allele. And the short wings is recessive allele, small f. Okay? So now, what's happening when the mating of the butterfly